It's MxRheyRhey. Welcome back to my art channel, and this is Art Talk, where we pretty much just hang out while I do some kind of art. So what you're seeing right now is my handmade watercolor paper. If you've been on the channel for a little bit, you know that I make my own watercolor paper, or I am starting to, and I sell them on my Etsy shop. Well, this particular size, which is roughly a 14 by 18, is not available on the shop, but I have made enough of them that I feel like it's probably better if I, you know, do a paint test on them, just because they're a bigger version of the smaller paper that I make does not mean that they will have the same amount of quality, even though I like exactly scaled everything up, like mathematically, to do it, to try and do it just that way. But yeah, I have about like 50 of these 14 by 18 papers, and I have yet to actually try to, well, before now, paint on any of them. And so this is a bit of a twofer video where I do my first large scale watercolor painting, and I get to test out the quality of my giant sized watercolor paper. If you're wondering why it looks like it was absolutely crumpled under a compressor, it is because the frame that I use to make these larger paintings is actually a, what is it, deconstructed bee frame. My parents used to be beekeepers. We still have all of the equipment, so I took one of their larger bee frames for an empty box. I took out the hexagonal little frame part that actually is in the middle, put window screen over it, and voila, I was able to make my larger paper. And the paper pulp that I use specifically, the other reason why this looks like it's a crumbled mess, even though it has been flattened for like at least over a month, is because I used absolutely 100% recycled paper. This paper is actually like, it's actually paper that my mom has been shredding in her paper shredder and throwing away for a while, and I thought since, like, I feel bad because recycling and all that, we can't just throw all this paper away, I would start making paper out of it for myself. I ended up getting another side business for it. And so some of the shredded paper that she has were things like envelopes and like other files. There were staplers in there. So there's a lot of like shredded plastic also within my recycled paper. And that creates all of these like rough, sharp ridges, and it makes it like a super rough textured paper. I don't know if you saw there in the beginning at the close-up of the paper, without all of the wrinkles, it actually has more of like a cold press sort of frame with, because of the window screen on my paper molds. But yeah, so that is the explanation of how I made the paper and why it looks the way it does. So for one, this is a critique of my own paper. This, maybe it was just because I feel like my brushes were too small for the size of the paper that I had personally. I would have been so much more comfortable if I had like an actual mop sized brush to paint all in these, because I feel like it absorbs water and color really quickly. So if you have like uber natural watercolor brushes that hold all of the water, this is pretty much the paper for you. I feel like that's a setback though, that it absorbs water so quickly that it makes it, for me personally, like 2 years into watercolor painting, it made it difficult for me to put the color where I needed it to go. Even with watering the paper down first. So I don't know if that's because of my skills as a painter. I personally, if I were to decide to start going bigger with my paintings, I would want this paper personally to be less absorbent of water. And granted, this is like version like two of like four or five that I've done through the bigger sizes of paper. I'm very methodical when it comes to things that I create. Sorry. But so granted, this is like the lower quality of paper that I already have. I already know that the stack that I made just this last week is perfect for this. But then another part of this that I would absolutely rectify as soon as I get more recyclable paper that maybe doesn't have plastic in it. Some of the crevices, I guess, with the larger brushes made it a little hard to get like the color wash consistency that I wanted. So if you are kind of liking so far how my painting is going, and you're liking like the textures and everything and how it looks, you would really like this. I think this would qualify as like extra rough paper. Yeah, so there's that. I have been wanting to experiment with rough paper just because that's a semi-common texture of paper that people who do urban sketching use, or just like really loose watercolorists, because of that texture. So if you are like the style of loose painting, which I feel like I was trying to use while I was doing this paper test, then by all means let me know what you think of this paper and if there was anything that you're specifically looking for larger sizes like this, because this is by no means the final product. I have versions that are better, but they can always be improved. If you wanted paper this like 14 by 18 inches size, let me know down in the comments. I would love to know if I am wasting my time on this bigger size paper. But that's always really intrigued me, is like the bigger sized like watercolor paintings. Anytime you see them like on Instagram or anything, like it makes sense because the app itself makes you seem like very, very small. Smaller things do well on the app. But like a large watercolor painting that's like the size of a window, I feel like that's so rare to see on the internet and like mainstream artist collaborations, or like sharing, like when you're on Instagram, like sharing of it. I've never seen watercolor paper or paintings that were large, and so like it really fascinated me and wanted to try it, and that's why I started making this larger paper. Where was I going with that? I think that's all I was going to do about my thoughts on the paper itself. I did my own like review critique of my own paper that I make. Okay, so this I guess is like a review video. Onto the lining part of my watercolors. Yes, I do love colored lines with my paintings. I feel like I feel like this is something that is actually helpful with the texture of the paper. The roughness didn't make the line straight and made it more natural, which, as you have seen, this is a natural landscape painting, so it worked really well. Overall, with all of this, I really liked how this came out, though, like with the sketching and putting it down on paper. I think the nature of the painting worked really well with the paper that I was painting on. Yeah, like I love the looseness of like how I did the trees and everything, and I feel if I were to redo it all over again, which I'm not going to do, it just took me a while and I was super anxious about doing something big, I would have made this part with the mushrooms and the tree trunk bigger, because I feel like that was what I was focusing on the most with this painting. I am not used to painting big in the scale wise anyway, so granted I don't know how to properly fill a space and make it seem natural. But I think for what it's worth, this painting came out really well, and I'm sorry if you saw, I could not help but put sparkles in my painting. I am refinding my love of glitter and how it can be utilized for the better. So Something else that I did with this painting is the final product. One, I have to work on it tearing with tape, but also this is super deckled. I actually feel like for this bigger paper, hand torn looks just so much better. So that's something I'm also gonna have to like rectify with my other pieces of paper. But yes, this is the final product of it. I hope you guys liked this video and liked my ranting on my own handmade paper. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. I hope you like it. Let me know down in the comments below for anything. Bye.